I will explain how the decision tree's algorithm works on supervised classification to create thresholds and how to find the best features for dividing the patterns. How to build a decision tree. Suppose that a set contains samples of different patterns. The decision tree aims to refine it into single subsamples or single pattern subsamples. Suppose we have these two features here and the patterns are divided like this. The samples here have the pattern of circles and the pattern of triangles. When the set contains only samples belonging to a single pattern, the decision tree is composed by a leaf. For example, if we make a threshold here dividing this feature, we will divide this sample set into, from here to the top, all elements are triangle, and in the right branch we have different classes or patterns here. But in this case, we create a leaf. This is how the decision tree works. And these patterns here are left for a second test, a second threshold, which will try to divide them. But how to define these thresholds? So we need a purity measure of each node to improve the feature selection. Let's show how this works. Suppose we have a set of events, let's call them P1, P2 until Pn. We have the measure called entropy that aims to answer how uncertain we are of the outcome. The entropy is calculated using this equation. Suppose the entropy of a set of events is this sum, considering that we have each one of the events times the log of the same event. And we have a measure which is called gain that answers this question. How much entropy of this training set some test reduced? So the decision tree algorithm, it goes from one by one, considering the features and find how much of the entropy this feature or making a test using this feature, how much of the entropy this test reduced. And the gain is calculated by the information value for all the features minus the information for the nodes. This will result in the gain of the feature. Suppose we have, for example, two features called pixel min and area, and we have three patterns. Forest with four samples, clear cut with three samples, and roads with two samples. Suppose that we are trying to split the data, the features, using the feature pixel min. When we make this test, pixel min is higher than a threshold, suppose 70, we will divide our sample set in these two groups. From the left branch we have forest and clear cut, and the right branch we have forest and road. So we can see that with this threshold we could not divide a single feature in the left or in the right branch. But how to calculate the gain of this feature? The information value for all the samples, four elements of forest, two elements of clear cut, and three elements of road, minus the information value for the two branches. In this, the left side, three forest, two clear cut, and no roads. And the right, one forest, two roads, and three roads. And to calculate the information value for all the features, we have 4 divided by the sum of them, which is 9, and then 2 and then 3, and result in this value. And to calculate the information value for the branches, we have to do this individually. The first one here, the left branch, the right branch, and both, which result in the information value for the branches. So the result gained for using pixel min is the information for all features, 1.53 minus 0.89, which results in 0.63. Now let's test the feature area, and suppose we found a threshold of 50. When we use this feature, we resulted that in the left branch we have all elements of forest and all of road, and in the right branch we have all elements of clear cut. So visually we can see that this test is better than the previous. And let's see if the gain is also higher than the other. To calculate the gain for the feature area, we have to make the gain for the information value for all the elements minus the information value for left and right branches. Now calculating the information value for the left and right branches, we have this value. You can see that the information value for the right branch, the one with only clear cut, is 0, which means that the entropy is very low, or is 0, because we have all elements of the same class. So this is a good threshold. Then the information value for both branches, and the final calculation, the information value for all features, 1.53 minus information value for the nodes, 0.76, which result in this value, 0.76. Now comparing both, we have that the information, the gain for area is 0.76, which is higher than the gain for pixel min. So this means that we can select the feature area, that the feature area will create a better threshold in this case. And this node seems, using only clear-cut samples, this node is pure, with only clear-cut pattern. Therefore, we have a lower entropy, and consequently a higher gain. And in the end of the classification, or in the end of the detection of a feature, we can see that the area feature were selected, and in this side we create a leaf, which means that in this side we are not going to process anymore. Now we need to continue to find another feature and another threshold to split forest from roads. But we are going to use the same approach, that to calculate the gain for each one of the features. And that's how decision tree works inside. Thanks for your attention.